Hello, second graders. Today we are going to be learning about architecture and art. We are going to do a few things. We are going to start by meeting an architect. His name is Steve Beck, and guess what? He's my dad. He's pretty cool. We are then going to look at Seesaw and think about, if I were to design a building, what would I design? And then we are going to make a blueprint. A blueprint is a basic plan that helps others understand what it is you want to make. So get ready, you're being hired as architects today in art class. Hello, second graders, this is Steve Beck. Steve Beck is an architect. Architects plan, design, and oversee the construction of buildings. To do this job, you need to create designs that are appealing to the eye, but also functional and serve the people it is made for. So what types of jobs have you had as an architect?
Strictly design work, where you're doing the pretty drawings that someone designs from, and I've also gone out on construction sites, you know, in your work boots and your hard hat to oversee what people are putting together based on your drawings. Not only are the design aspects of it, but they're what's called the construction documents, which are the drawings that are given to the tradespeople to show them how to put the pieces together to build a building.
Which do you like more?
I like to do all of it. So I don't mind being in the office a certain amount of time, but I also, being involved in the construction side of things makes you a better architect because you understand what someone has to go through to make your design work. We're juggling aesthetics, we're juggling cost, and we're also juggling functionality. So a building can be beautiful, but not function well. A building can be beautiful and cost way too much money to have it built.
What types of skills do you need as an architect?
Certainly one of the skills is being able to see in three dimensions. So typically drawing in a two-dimensional reality, trying to represent three-dimensional things. Now granted, that's changing recently with computer software and the ability to draw in 3D and the ability to move around that, but having the ability in your head to put those pieces together and understand that you have a column and you have a beam and those and the other column or the other beam that goes into that, how those pieces interact and what happens when the geometry changes on those, and being able to quickly do that in your head is extremely beneficial to being able to be a better architect.
What do you need to think about to make the design usable?
Of sort of an emergency exit. You have a bunch of people trying to get out of the building in an emergency, and you physically want to make sure you have the space to do that. But then there are also visual and other aspects of it. Like Frank Lloyd Wright famously, in his playroom in his own house, has a very small and confining hallway, and almost like a tunnel that enters into it. But when you then get into the main room, it opens up. So he was doing things playing with space and understanding that when you visually and sort of almost physically confine somebody, it made that transition from one space to the other much more dramatic.
When you designed, he actually designed our house. I'll put up a picture. Anything specific that you thought about for our family as you were building it?
Well, one of the things we wanted was we wanted to take advantage of being on the corner, so we have windows on three sides of the house. We also wanted an opportunity to see the kids playing, whether that was in the yard or even as they got older, playing on the sidewalks in front and alongside our house. So one thing we did was had the garage separate from the house, so that allowed us opportunities on these three sides.
Why did you choose to be an architect?
And I think it started when we did a project in sixth grade where we were designing our house. We did a picture, a 3D drawing of the outside of what it should look like. I think we did floor plans, and then we cut out pictures of various rooms. So what we thought the bedroom should look like, what we thought the living room should look like, and it all went together in a book. House plan. Every week in the newspaper, and I used to cut them out and study them and see what I liked about one plan versus the other.
Hello, architects. Today, we are going to be making a plan. It is so important that before we build something, we make a plan so that others can understand what we want to make. So, what's really important about architecture is you want your building to look good, but it also has to be usable. Think back to the castles we made last week. We important fundamentals of a building. We had walls. We drew lines within our giant shapes to show different wall structures, to show the different building sizes. We already started making the roofs. We added different geometric shapes to the tops of our roofs. And maybe some of you even included doors, places for people to go into your castle. Should these slides 3, 4, and 6, and you're gonna draw a little check mark by the one you think you want to do. For slide 1, will your design be for a place for you or others to live in, such as a house, apartment, a condo, or a hotel? Will your design be for a place to gather, such as a concert hall, a museum, or a stadium? Or maybe a place to work, such as a skyscraper, a school, an office building, or a warehouse? Will your design include maybe minimal colors and shapes, or will your design include patterns or designs? Will your design have any special features, such as something special built in? The Milwaukee Museum has wings, and I'm gonna include a little gif showing them opening and closing. They open and close throughout the day. But maybe if you're designing a school, what would you want your school to include? Would it include a zip line? Would it include a place for everyone to hang out and eat lunch together? As you can see here, we have 2 examples. Maybe your building is made to grow plants. Maybe it has solar panels on the top of the roof. Maybe your building is made for the ocean. Maybe it sits on top of the ocean and you get a little view into the waters below. Keep things healthy, takes the plastic out of the water. Or maybe your building has a really unique shape. If you get to it, you can start drawing your design and you can upload a photo to the Seesaw template here. Once you're done, tap that green check for approval. Once you filled out the Seesaw template, now you can get to drawing. Grab your sketchbook and a pencil. In my Seesaw template, I chose a place to work. When I think of warehouses, I think that they're usually just normal concrete buildings, not much going on. And I thought that it would be really interesting to add on special features to make this a really unique place to work. Architects have to think about who will be using their buildings. If I'm using a warehouse, that means a lot of people work there. So I added on a parking lot. In my warehouse, I knew that I wanted to include a pattern or unique design. I chose to change the front of the building to a circular shape and then add on these 3D features on the top of the building. I included a few doors, but then I realized that I could use the windows to my advantage. When I started adding on these circular windows, I realized it kind of looked like a face. I started to think about what special features I can include. I thought that it would be really interesting to use that wall to my advantage on the side and maybe include an artist mural. And maybe the roof would be a great spot for a community garden.
Let's go way back. Look back and reminisce on how it began and how I became the architect that I am. I knew I was an architect since the age of 2. Standing in my crib, I had a fascinating view. Riding in my stroller, the sights were amazing. Everywhere I looked was stone, brick, and glazing. My second word form, first word function. My parents were amazed I could connect that conjunction. Looking like a zebra, yeah, I'm wearing white and black. Too busy building structures, ain't got no time to nap. We're architects, and we knew it from the start. A perfect combination of building and art. We've been creating since the age of 2. And now we're designing a better city for you. My skills blossom at the age of 6. Dropping instant designs with pickup sticks. Call me Abraham, I had skill with the Lincoln Logs. Designed a mini house for my dogs. I was a boss at Jenga, schooling all of my friends. Check out my desk, my great assortment of pens. Pulled my first all-nighter by the age of 9. With Legos I built an immaculate design. We're architects, and we knew it from the start. A perfect combination of building and art. We've been creating since the age of 2. And now we're designing a better city for you.
Built a dollhouse out got a foam core board for my architect Barbie. She was floored. Skipped a family trip to go see Mickey Mouse. Rather go to Falling Waters to see Frank's famous house. Donned a drawing tube instead of a book bag. It was the start of my architect swag. Sorted all my clothes according to hues and made a sketch up of my bedroom with a 3D view.
We're architects, and we knew it from the start. A perfect combination of building and art. We've been creating since the age of two, and now we're designing a better city for you.
Proposing skylines with in Sim City. And in Minecraft, I built a home that was pretty. Designed a treehouse and brought to fruition. But I had to cut costs to save for my tuition. Mowed 100 lawns to buy a 3D printer. And took up woodworking, ounce, a splinter. Love to design and build, it's what I do. I'm gonna be an architect, how about you?
So get up, grab your pencils, let's design the city. Inspire the world as we make it pretty. We are creators, as you can infer. Come join us and discover architecture.